Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, I'm going to convert a table that I created in Microsoft Word that uses both English and Spanish and convert it into a PDF and make sure the table is still accessible. But before we get to that, take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. I have a file open that has a table with both English and Spanish and some PNG checkboxes in it. And I want to convert this over to PDF. The first thing I'm going to do is save this Word file. And then under the Acrobat tab, I'm going to select Create PDF. And then I'm going to select Save. And I have already made this table accessible in Microsoft Word. So it should come over to PDF already mostly accessible. All right, so let's scroll out a little bit. The first thing I wanna do is check the tags panel. To do that, I'm going to open up the tags panel on the far left side of the page. And it looks like my table has already been tagged and we have a section tag. It looks like we also have a blank P tag. So let's go ahead and make sure we make this document accessible. The first thing I like to do is instead of the section tag at the top, I'm going to make it a document tag. This will help it pass PDF UA and WCAG accessibility standards. So to do that, I'm going to right click the section tag, select properties, and type in the word document, and then select close. Then let's go ahead and address this P tag right away. I'm simply going to select the empty container, right click it, and change tag to artifact. And then for artifact type, I'm going to select page and select OK. Then I can delete the P tag out. Let's go ahead and walk through the cells of this table. So currently I have a table header, and a table header. And then we have multiple rows with our PNG images in them. So far, so good. Let's open up our table editor. I'm going to select the accessibility button and then the reading order tool. And then I'm going to adjust some settings on my reading order tool. And what I'm going to do is right click inside of the table and select table editor. All right, what this allows me to see is I have some TH tags at the top, but I feel like it's not displaying properly. So let's see what we can figure out here. Let's try that again. Right click, table editor. I'm going to hold my shift key and select these table headers at the top. Right click, select table cell properties. And for the scope, the column is already set. That's great. And then select OK. It feels like something is wrong with this table for some reason, but I can't quite spot it. Let's go ahead and start with, I'm going to remove these blank P tags out. Now there's a couple different ways to do this. I could hit the delete key, but a better method is to right click and change the tag to an artifact. And I'm going to need to do this for each time that this blank tag is showing up. All right, I gotta move my floating head around. I'm finding the blank tag, right clicking it and changing it to an artifact. This one has, so I'm selecting both of those, change tag to artifact. And all I'm doing right now is trying to clean up my table structure because it just felt like something was out of order. All right, we now have the table structure in place. Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker and let's find out what's going on. All right, looks like we're missing a couple of things. Nested alternate text failed. Let's open up our tags panel and figure out what's going on. I'm going to expand one of these rows, right click the figure tag, select properties, and it looks like that it's placed the alt text on both my figure tag and the path tag. So I think to fix this error, I need to remove my alt text from the path tag. Let's go ahead and test this. So I removed the alt text from the path tag, but it did remove it from both. Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker and see what's happening. All right, now it's telling me the alt text is removed. Let's see if we can figure this out. I'm going to go ahead and remove the alt text from all of these figure tags because something is acting funny. Now let's run the accessibility checker. All right, so I now at least have just missing alt text. So there's a few different ways I can fix this. I'm gonna go ahead and fix it from the accessibility checker panel here. I'm going to right click and select fix, and it's going to allow me to add the alt text in here. So I can say user verified, tables use headers, and select the next button. We can say user verified images have alternate text. The next checkbox, we can say user verified document uses headings. And the reason for this is because this is the top level header for this column. All right, we can also say user verified links are properly formatted. And the last one will be user verified color contrast passes testing, and select save and close. And now we're getting a nested alt text failure. Well, it seems I've created a game of whack-a-mole here. Let's see if we can figure out how to fix this nested alt text. All right, so I seem to have found a fix. Basically, what's happening is when I apply alternate text, it gives me a failure under nested alternate text and vice versa. So if I show in the tags panel and I remove the alternate text here and then run the accessibility checker, it then tells me that my figure is missing alt text. So what I've done is if I move the path tag outside of the figure tag, it seems to remove the error for me. So let's go ahead and just run down this path and see what happens. All right, let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker. That made it pass everything, but now I'm worried that this isn't gonna be read properly because it's still missing alternate text. So it looks like that option didn't work either. What else can we do? Let's try using the reading order tool, and I'm going to try to tag this as a figure. And let's just see if that does anything different. It looks like that it removed one of the rows, so I need to re-add in that TD tag. And let's go ahead and try to give this alt text again. Like close. Oh goodness. So I'm still... Okay. So I just found something really interesting deep in a forum. And it says that if you put alt text on the table, that sometimes you'll get this phantom error. So I'm going to go back to Word and I'm going to remove the alt text from the table properties. And let's create a new test file and select save. All right, so I have my new file open. Let's take a look at the tags panel. Real quick, I'm going to change this tag to a document tag. And then we're going to artifact this P tag. All right, and here's what I want to check. I first want to see the figure tag does have alt text. Let's run the accessibility checker. Wow, there's definitely a bug here. That's crazy. I spent a good 20 minutes when creating this video and just found the fix to this problem. So this just goes to show, I've been doing this for years and years and I still learned something new. So here's what I learned. If you apply alternate text to that table in Word, you get nesting problems with links and images in your PDF table. So let's go back to our tags panel and just validate that our alt text is correct. And this looks pretty good. User has verified that all images in the document use alternate text. On our other file, we kept getting this weird error of going back and forth between nested alt text and figures missing alt text. Now that we've addressed that in Microsoft Word, I am no longer going to be putting alternate text on my tables in Word. So now we can actually just fix the rest of the stuff in this document. And let's open up the accessibility button, the reading order tool, right click, and we can edit table summary. And then we can select OK. Close. Let's save this file and check again. Looks like mostly everything passes except for we're missing a title. So let's right click the title, select fix. Now, I also want to make sure that my Spanish text has been properly recognized. So I'm going to select that text, and under the options button, I'm going to select find tag from selection. And I want to right click this P tag and select properties. And it does appear that the tag is already been updated to be Spanish Mexico. So because I set that language setting in Microsoft Word in my previous video, it did in fact come through. But if this wasn't here, essentially what you want to do is find all of the text that contains Spanish in it and right click the tags, select properties, and change the language dropdown to be Spanish, and then select close. Now the next step of this, of fixing this file, would be to take it into into the PAC 2021 checker and check it for PDF UA and WCAG standards. But for sake of this video, this is going to be the end. So thank you for coming with me on that journey. I feel like I learned a lot, and I hope you did. Thank you for watching.